What would you do if trick-or-treaters showed up on your doorstep? In September.
Trick-or-treat!
Probably slam the door, right? But what if they have a very good reason?
Hi, my ex-wife has the kids for Halloween, so I promised them I would take them trick-or-treating. Do you have any candy?
Yeah, we do. Hang on one second.
Okay, thank you.
This was...
Trick-or-treat!
What a great way to meet your neighbors.
Do we have any candy?
Look at that!
Take as many as you want.
When these people open the door at first, they're surprised. Then as the story goes on, you can feel them softening up and their sympathetic response kicks in.
Snack packs, guys. You guys like snack packs? They just bought them, they're fresh.
The more personal information the father uses.
My ex-wife has my kids on Halloween, so I promised them I would take them trick-or-treating.
The more emotionally he engages the homeowners.
I bet mom's new boyfriend wouldn't have gotten you snack packs.
The more he's able to emotionally manipulate them to get them to do things they wouldn't normally do.
This is all I have. Cheese.
Some baby bell cheese. What do you say to the nice woman?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Do you have crackers with the cheese?
But what happens when dad changes the story?
Trick or treat!
Hi, this is a little awkward. We're gonna be out of the country for Halloween, so I promised my kids that I'd take them trick-or-treating.
Have any candy?
No, I don't.
Somebody go on vacation does not give us nearly a sympathetic response because that's something more indulgent.
Do you have any candy?
I got nothing.
Oh, all my candy!
Eventually, at some point, people are gonna lose their patience. And they're gonna be like, okay, kid, get out of here. It's not Halloween.
You don't have any candy?
No.
Nothing?
Sorry.
Do you have any Sour Patch Kids?
Nothing.
Skittles?
Nothing.
Almonds?
Big. I like dad number two more.
I think trick-or-treating in September is fine. I hate crowds.
Trick-or-treat!